protect me. You look at the text and you see this. Look at verse 27. Daniel chapter 3, verse 27. This is good, y'all. Then the high officers, officials, governors, and advisors, they crowded around Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. And they saw that the fire had not touched them, Jesus. Not a hair on their heads was singed. And their clothing was not scorched, Jesus. They didn't even smell of smoke, Jesus. God was protecting them from what should have killed them. How many people know that God has been protecting you from everything that was designed to destroy you? Jesus.
So you got to hold on to the promise even as you go through the process. If you're fighting with invisible battles, stay strong in this season. You don't have to reveal to the world what you're fighting with, but you've got to reveal it to God. You've got to say, God, I've been struggling to hear from you because I haven't been in the mood. God, I just want to be honest. God, I know there's a call on my life, God, but I've run from it because I haven't been in the mood to serve. God, I haven't done what you've asked me to do because I haven't been in the mood to be obedient. Come on, somebody. If you ever become honest with God, God can do something amazing in your life.
You got to have a committed prayer life.
Yes. And when you begin to reevaluate your peace, and you see, you know what? I realize my peace is fleeting.
Yeah, I need this.
I realize I'm running on an empty tank, and that's what cues you. You know what? Yeah. I need to pray.
Are you running on empty?
Are you running on empty? You know, are you running on empty?
Too many of us are trying to pour out from an empty tank.
Yes.
When we got a container that is unfilled, but we're trying to fill everybody else's cup. Yes. And the devil is looking saying, yes, please try to pour nothing into other people.
Yes.
You don't have anything to offer, but you're steadily trying to pour. If you would only sit down in the presence of God, if you would only bow down in his presence and allow Jesus to fill your cup, then you would be more fulfilled and more inspired and more motivated, more encouraged to do what God has called you to do. But sometimes we're not committed to praying.